everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is not a figure review or a figure review. It is a countdown video, and this is a response to Darcy J Reviews and Negromaster Cole. I will put their channel links in the description. They did a video of top 10 Star Wars figures, and I decided to do mine because mine normally change except my, like, probably my top 4 maybe, or 5. So, check out their channels and subscribe if you haven't already. So, let's begin. Number 10 is The Power of the Jedi Aura Sing. There are a total of 4 Aura Sings. This one, from the Saga Collection, the Clone Wars, and the Vintage Collection / Discover the Force Collection. The Saga Collection one and the Clone Wars ones are not from the movies. The Saga Collection one is from Expanded Universe, and then Clone Wars one is from Clone Wars, obviously. The Discover the Force one and / Vintage Collection one and this one are from when she makes an appearance, short appearance in Episode 1. And I actually prefer this one over the Discover the Force one. Yes, the newer one has probably more detail and more articulation. It's a fact. She has more articulation. But I just, something about this one, I really like the detail she does have on this one. The belt has nice detail. I really like the face sculpt. And she has nice reddish orangish hair. And you can see the beads in there. She's a good one, in my opinion. And if you don't know, Aura is my favorite bounty hunter. So that is number 10. Number 9 is from the Princess Leia collection, and it is Leia in her iconic white outfit with the buns. The outfit is all soft goods except for her belt. The face sculpt, I think, looks a lot like Carrie Fisher. The buns are not too big, which is good. And of course, she's from Power of the Force, so she doesn't have that much articulation. But articulation isn't everything to me. So, number 8 is the Movie Heroes Wave 3 Darth Vader, and I really like this Darth Vader. His face sculpt looks a lot like him from Empire. This is an Empire Vader. The detail on his pants and his chest plates are really nicely done. My favorite part is the cape. I think the cape has a lot of nice detail. Really nicely done. The only thing that bugs me is the lightsaber. I don't like how it's molded in. I wish you could take it out, but I don't really play with him. He's more displayed, so he's a really nice one. He has good articulation, you know, bunched elbows and knees and stuff like that. Number 7 is a Clone Wars figure, and it is Clone Wars Darth Sidious, and this is, of course, the earlier appearances of Darth Sidious. Now, I haven't seen all the episodes of the Clone Wars. It's something I need to do when I get time, eventually. I do like this. Now, I'm pretty sure all you see Sidious in as a hologram, but I really do. You can see the face sculpt up there. It's a good one. You can see the eyes, but the hood is not removable. But he does have pretty nice detail on his little tunic and pants. He does not have knee or ankle articulation, which is fine. If you go on Rebel Scum, they actually did take the hood off, and you can see the face sculpt. And this is the only Clone Wars Palpatine. I would have liked to see Chancellor Palpatine and updated Sidious. This one's a little harder to find, as you guys probably know. Number 6 is the Vintage Collection Bespin Nuke. And I don't have all the Vintage Collection nukes. I'm missing 2, I think, maybe 3. But I have seen them, and out of all of them, I think this is the best one. I love it when figures look like they popped right out of the movie or TV show or comic or whatever they come from. And this is a perfect example. I think the detail on him is really nice. He has a lot of nice articulation. You can get him in great action poses. The face sculpt looks a lot just like Mark Hamill, in my opinion. And just an overall great figure. He comes with great accessories. And this is my favorite look of Luke Skywalker. Number 5 is the Vintage Collection, / Legacy Collection, Slave Leia. Now, they pretty much are the same figure, except the Vintage Collection one does not have the extra legs, and the paint apps are a little different. I really like this one. I do have all the Vintage Collection Leias, except the ones from the OTC line, which I do need those, which eventually I do plan to get, because one of my goals is to have every Leia figure made. And I like this one. The detail on her is pretty nice. Her dress is soft goods. The face sculpt out of all of them looks like Carrie Fisher the most, in my opinion. The hair on the Vintage Collection Leia is a little dark on all of them, but you get used to it. And the slave outfit is actually one of my favorite outfits. And so that is number 5. Number 4 is the Vintage Collection / Battle Pack. He was just released again this year, and it is Darth Sidious. Darth Sidious is my favorite villain of Star Wars and third favorite character. This is a great figure. I love his accessories, especially his lightning piece. I love his how you can take his hood off, and he has a great face sculpt. It's just one of those evil Palpatine face sculpts. Great. And his cloak and little coat is soft goods, and he is just a great figure overall. He came out this year in the Battle Pack, but I don't think he comes with the lightning piece. So if you want that, you're going to have to get the Vintage Collection release. Number 3, another Vintage Collection figure, and it is Ayla Secura. As you guys all know, Ayla is one of my favorite Jedi. I really love this figure. It looks just like Amy Allen, who played her, in my opinion. The detail was really nice on her tentacles, or Luca, I think what they're called. I'm not sure. The articulation is really nice, of course, being from the Vintage Collection. Figures have a lot of good articulation. And one of the best VC figures, actually. Number 2 is, of course, the Black Series Padme Amidala. Now, I'm sure all of you were wondering when Padme was going to come into the list. Or you knew one or two would be Padme. If you're not a huge Padme fan and you just want one Padme in your collection, this is the one to get. It has really nice articulation. The face sculpt does look like Natalie Portman. It could be a little better, but the detail on her hair is really nice. I love the next 2 scratches. She comes with her blaster and pistol fell out here. And it's just a really nice one. I think every collection should at least have one Padme in it. Number 1 is actually the OTC Queen Amidala from Inner Salvation Gown. This is my favorite Queen Amidala figure. The detail on her dress is really nicely done, and it's all plastic, not soft goods. The face sculpt's a pretty good one. They did miss the white makeup, but that's okay. And it's just a great figure. I would love to get this one carded. Darth CJ Reviews did honorable mentions, and I'm going to do that too. He did 3. And the first one is the Clone Wars Ayla Secura, and this one is one of the best Clone Wars figures, in my opinion. I don't have all the Clone Wars figures, but it's one of my goals. It's a great figure, great detail, looks like she just popped out of the shell. And, of course, good articulation. Then next is another Padme one, and this one's from the Legacy Collection / Evolutions pack. And it's, of course, the same outfit as the Black Series one, but before she gets cut, and I think the face sculpt looks a lot like Natalie Portman. Good articulation, her poncho is soft goods, and it's just a great one. Next is this Darth Vader. Now, I'm not sure what he comes from, but I like him. I like his face sculpt. I like the detail on him, and he has good articulation. Thanks for watching. Bye.